Welcome to the ARE 5.0 Exam Strategies video, brought to you by NCAR. In this video, we'll explore several tips and techniques to help you navigate and take a division of ARE 5.0, including pointers on item types and scoring, navigating to a case study during your exam, and approaching case study resources efficiently. Be sure to watch our ARE 5.0 exam navigation video for tips on navigating the new exam interface, and check out our ARE 5.0 test prep videos for more information about the content covered in each division. All six ARE 5.0 divisions are organized the same way, varying only in the number of items and the testing time. Each appointment will begin with a few introduction screens and end with a few final reminders and an exit survey. You can learn more about what to expect from those portions in our ARE 5.0 exam navigation video. In the next few minutes, we'll focus on how to approach the exam content you'll encounter within each division. All ARE 5.0 divisions include individual items, case study items, and pretest items. The number of items vary depending on the size of the division. Larger divisions, like project planning and design and project development documentation, have a few more case study and pretest items than the others. Pretest items are included on all divisions, so NCARB can collect statistics and determine if they should be used in the future. They're distributed randomly throughout the exam content portion, but are unscored and have no impact on your overall results. Only your performance on individual and case study items determines whether you pass the division. Since there is no way of knowing which questions might be a pretest item, it's best to approach all items as if they will affect your score. You'll see all five ARE 5.0 item types, including the new hotspot and drag and place, throughout the exam's individual, case study, and pretest items. While the type of item used in a particular question will depend on what is being assessed, keep in mind that each item was designed to be user-friendly. Focus on understanding the content rather than worrying about the different item types. If you choose to leave an item unanswered, it will be marked as incomplete and be scored as incorrect. Remember, all scored items are worth 1 point each, so while it is important to answer everything, it's also important not to spend too long on any one item. You can always mark an item for review and return to it later. Each division has a minimum score you must meet in order to pass. Your total score is determined by adding up the number of points earned. In other words, the total number of questions answered correctly. While you should answer all of the items in a division, you don't need to answer them in a specific order. Individual items are located at the beginning of each content portion of the exam, and case studies are located at the end. Using the exam summary button, you can navigate directly to a case study whenever you feel most comfortable. Whether that means starting at the beginning and working your way through the exam in a linear order, starting with the case studies before answering the individual items, or warming up on a few individual items before going through the case study, and then return to the remaining individual items to complete your exam. The use of case studies is new in ARE 5.0, so we recommend spending a little time planning how to approach these items. Each case study will introduce a project scenario and include a set of related resource documents. The number and specific types will vary depending on the division, but additional time has been built into the test so you can familiarize yourself with the resources before you begin answering the related items. All items that are associated with a case study will refer back to these documents. Remember, the provided resources will need to be analyzed and evaluated in order to determine the correct responses. The resources for each case study are displayed as PDFs, and there are several tools you can use to make navigating resources easier. These include a keyword search function, which allows you to type a word and then navigate to specific areas, and avoid just scrolling through the document to find a certain section. The scrolling method is not the quickest because each resource page takes a moment to load on the screen. The bookmark and table of contents tools will help you navigate through longer resources more efficiently. The zoom and pan functions enable you to see the resources in detail. NCARB recommends two different approaches to becoming familiar with the resources in a case study. The first approach is to spend some time going through each of the resources before looking at any of the related items, so you know what types of information are contained in each resource. At the test center, you will be provided scratch paper and pencils so you can take notes about key pieces of information. A second approach is to quickly familiarize yourself with each resource and then jump right into the items, referring back to the resources as each item requires. Whichever approach you use, remember that you are not required to read every single word of every resource, or to memorize them. If you attempt to do this, you will not complete the exam in the allotted time. To recap, all items are worth 1 point. Answer all items as if they will count. You can take case studies at any point during your test, and budget your time wisely. We hope this video provides you with a few helpful tips and techniques as you prepare to take your first ARE 5.0 division. And remember, lots of people are studying for the ARE right now, so join the conversation. You can stay on top of the latest news and connect with NCARB and your colleagues with these sites. Be sure to check out our new ARE community created just for ARE 5.0. Take a look at our other ARE 5.0 videos, and thanks for watching.